There is an author who says he had two fathers, one rich dad, one poor dad. Ridiculous, right? How come a one person can have two fathers? So he says, one father is highly educated. He had PhD, he has completed his 4 years of undergraduate education, 2 years, and he was an intelligent guy. The other father, he has not even completed his 8th grade. Both were very successful in their career. They worked very hard throughout their lives. They earned good money also as income. So one person always struggled, was not able to save money. Whereas the other person created a big investment. One person when died, he left thousands and millions of dollars to their family. Whereas when the other person died, he left bills to be paid. Poor. So good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to talk about a book called Rich Dad, Poor Dad and its excerpts, written by Robert Kiyosaki, where he says he has got two fathers. In reality, the rich father belonged to his friends, where both cared for him and they have given him how to earn money in a different way. So in that, the rich father would always say, you make money work for you. The poor always suggest, you work to earn money. So the author says, proper physical exercise will increase your chances for health. Similarly, proper mental exercise will increase your chances for great wealth. The poor father always believed that rich should pay tax to take care of the less fortunate. On the other hand, the rich father always thought taxes punish the rich who produce and reward the ones who don't produce. The poor father always thought house is my biggest investment, greatest wealth. Whereas the rich always said, if that is the biggest investment, okay, if it has won in a, sorry, if you have bought it in a loan, it's the biggest liability then of the world. He said, if that is your biggest investment, then you are in trouble. And the rich always said, money has power. But what is more important is that you need to learn how to manage money and you need to learn how money works for you so that you can gain power over it and you can start begin building great wealth. The rich, as I said, always created a big investment. The poor always struggled to save even a single dollar. Where the poor father always said, you write your resume in an impressed way so that you can secure a job. Whereas the rich father always thought, you invest your time and also money and financial and also investments so that you can create job for others. So to put it in a nutshell, the author says, you invest a great amount of time and also money in finance and education. You get freedom out of it and you learn how to see and how to get to know about how money works for you. Don't focus on securing a job. Therein, throughout your life, you will be working to make others rich than that of yourself. There is a small story I like to say here. When there was an interview conducted to the person called Ray, he's basically owner of the McDonald's, he asked a question to the audience. He asked, what am I doing? People laughed. And they said, you are selling hamburger. And he said, no. The laughter came down. And he said, I'm not in the business of selling hamburger. I am in the business of doing real estate. Sounding a bit ridiculous, right? But what he does, he sets up his outlet, he buys land, He sets up a building, he sells hamburger. End of the day, when he closes down his business, what he gets? A big real estate wealth that will give big money like anything. So that is what he's saying. So my suggestion is that always focus on having good financial learning than that of trying to secure a job wherein you will be working always to make others rich. Thanks a lot, guys.